Alright, so let's begin now. Hang on, something is not right here. Is this a light? Hang on, let me fix this. Wait, what? Yes, there you go. Wait, what? Hey guys, it's Convolva here, and today we're going to go over 4 things to keep in mind to make the most out of your template projects. So it doesn't matter which DAW you use, these tips can be applied on any DAW in one way or other, so let's get right to it. So tip number 1, don't work on the template itself. Now more often than not, you will reach a point where you will run out of resources such as available mixer slots or CPU or RAM, and it seems like the template was just not concise enough for you to make any good use out of it. Does this sound familiar? If it does, then I have a solution for you. Just render the parts that you want to their bare bones. I like to consolidate using FL's Consolidate playlist track feature, which is over here. Just don't forget to make a selection around the timeline before doing this. Then save the MIDI by going into the piano roll, then here, and then here. Or you can just save by using Ctrl plus Shift plus M. Import them into a new project file and then you're done. Bam! You have just created 125 new mixer slots for your template. Tip number 2, save the presets. So this tip will help you when you have a certain sound that you really like in the template and you would like to incorporate that into your own projects and your own style of music. So let me show you what I mean. I usually go into the plugin and click on this arrow and then go to save preset as. You can save the preset anywhere on your PC. Then you can just go over to the project that you're working on and open the preset from here. If this does not work, then just drag and drop the preset from its original location and drop it over the plugin that you're working on and it should open. Whenever I'm looking into a template for sounds and synth presets, then I just save all of them before I use the template. This helps me save a ton of time in the end when I actually use these presets because I don't have to go back to the project and then, you know, find it again, try to import it and stuff like that. So I can just go into the presets and open it from there. Tip 3. Yeah, check the mixer layout. So sometimes people have like a really unique way of approaching their mixer layout, which could be really helpful if you bring them back into your own projects. For example, I picked up routing to submixes and docking to left from one of Seamless R's project files, and it has always been a part of my own workflow. So definitely have a look into that. Tip number 4, reduce the load. Now, in the tip number 1, I have recommended that you start a new project and then import these things into the new project. But for some reason, if you still want to work on the same project file that you downloaded from the internet and the CPU is just dying, then here's one thing that you can do. Just go into the PPQ settings of your project file, which is over here. This is more of a hit or miss kind of a situation because reducing PPQ may help you reduce the CPU load, but it may also mess up the quantization of your track. So here's a bonus tip for you guys. Just don't work on the same project file that you downloaded from the internet. Create a duplicate of the file and then start working on that. This will save a lot of hassle for you in the long run because then you don't have to like re-download the project file from the internet if you mess up the original file. And that about wraps it all up. Now, before I end this video, I would like to thank my patrons because of whom this video was possible. So thank you Itzidda and Vakines for making your generous contributions on my Patreon. It really does go a long way in helping the channel to sustain. If you guys are looking for good Psytrance templates for your own projects, then I have a whole playlist dedicated to this thing, which is over here. So you can just check that out if you are interested. Alright guys, that's it for today. Thanks for watching, and if you feel like I've helped you, then consider hitting the like and subscribe button and the bell icon.